you don't want to mess about too much in your own zone. And they used to get it out though, feeds Watson. Dean Holland loses the puck, but Williams holds him. Holland somehow plays beautifully on the ground and manages to get that one in, and Kippen will shoot. It's saved by Goss. He's not sure where it is. But if I don't know whether we caught that, watch this play from Dean Holland on the ground here.
Ian Pound's trying to take Watson to task over his antics there. But good shot blocking there by, I believe it was Tom Ledgard, throwing himself down and just preventing that low shot as it came in.
Indeed. If the Warriors had have scored then, Dean Holland would have been the player getting all the praise. Face off though, 5:18 gone. Still 0-0 here between the Coventry and Blaze and the Whitley Warriors. Here goes Binyarski. Just dumped that in for Nicklin to chase. Collected by Ricky Lawson. Loses it nearly. Bit of mild panic. Binyarski shoved to the ice. By Dowd, it nearly sneaks in off of Whitley Warriors' stick as Nicklin tries to play it across. Binyarski works his way out in front. Here is Nicklin though. Tries to find Binyarski, doesn't manage to, and Dean Holland will play that. Off the boards.
We've seen the Brynjarski-Stevenson line score like that before. It's almost a trademark play of theirs now, these wraparound attacks that they do. I mean, we saw an absolute beautiful wraparound from Ricky Brynjarski last week that we had no idea how he managed to score it.
Anakin to the corner. Puck is. Works it way through. Space for Nicklin. Nicklin will shoot his tab over.
And if he'd been there just a second or two earlier, that would have been 1-0.
Here is, once again, Ian Pound. The slightly questionable nickname of Pounder. Puck works it way out in front. Lawson has lost it. It's there! Snuck in eventually. Ledgard will claim it. Let's see if we can see exactly how that snuck in on the replay.
No, it's worked into the corner. Sends it into the front of the net. Work, dig for victory goal for Tom Ledgard.
So, 12:01. And the E&L Blaze lead 1-0 thanks to Tom Ledgard on the power play. Capitalising on their first power play opportunity, which bodes well for the future.
And E&L Blaze have missed that since Tom Ledgard was out. He's very good at those in front of net scrappy goals.
As well, can't play that out in front. Pollock with 30 seconds remaining, feeds that across. Hubbock has the fucking escape, manages to pull it out. Kippen now. Hobbit wants a call, doesn't get one. He'll have to get out the zone in order to allow the Blaze to attack. He does, but Williams will collect that one, shoots, it's saved. But Williams' stick instinctively goes up to try and play it. 10 seconds remaining in the first period. And the E&L Blaze will have to do something quickly if they want a 2-0 lead. Space for Tom Pease, shoots, it's blocked. And another one. That'll be the whistle. Tom Pease can't get the shot off.
It's too slow. Let's see that whole sequence again. Tom Pease, wham. It's deflected by Lawson. And there's a little bit of afters going on in front of there while we're watching the replay. But on the return, Tom Pease just too slow after the recent Williams shot.
Indeed, nothing particularly major on the shoving back and forth. So there we go, end of the first, and it's 1-0 to the E&L Blaze. Is this how you saw the game going so far, Chris, and expected?
I hoped it would go this way. I hoped it would be a few more Blaze goals, obviously. But E&L Blaze have done a good account of themselves. They've applied the pressure in the offensive zone when they've needed to. They've soaked up what pressure the Whitley Warriors have added in the Blaze zone, defensive zone. For the Warriors, they're doing a good job. They might be 1-0 down, but they are putting in a solid performance, in my opinion. Their shutdown work on the defense is brilliant. They've completely shut down the Brynjarski-Stevenson-Nicklin line, and that is the Blaze's deadliest line. At the end of the day, they don't have to shut down the other two lines that the Blaze have. They have to shut down that one line, because that will be the game-winning line for the Blaze tonight.
We'll chase that. We won't get to it, though, because Ashton Jenyon will get there first. 1:50 gone in the second period. Stevenson.
Jenyon does like his suicide passes this evening. That's the second time he's done that.
He does. As Nicklin drives one. And Lawson isn't sure where that is. He throws himself across.
Incredible.
To make the save. It's three again. That's three.
And how did that not go in?
I'm sorry, we're getting a replay of that wherever the puck is. Look at that save from Richie Lawson. And then again, all the way across.
Well, I said that the The Warriors needed to shut down the Vinyarski-Stevenson line, and they're still doing it.
Here is Janyan. He's chased by Callum Patterson.
Another suicide.
Nicklin will get that. Oh, that's a big one. Patterson on Nicklin. And Hubbock nearly breaks away with that one. Janyan battles for it.
The speed has stepped up a little. Definitely, and the physicality now as Mark Good's released.
And works his way in, scores Mark Good. I'm not sure how that one snuck in, actually.
Well, here we go, stretch pass to the blue line. I think Good had come off the bench, and it just fumbles past Adam Goss. He had it in his glove hand, I think.
But, indeed, Goss had made the initial save, and he looked unimpressed. You can see him rolling over onto his back.
I believe he intentionally sent that wide.
Big burst of activity here. And Sprakes in front for Hubbock. Score! Got a Hubbock left all alone in front of Richie Lawson. Look at this on the replay.
Nicklin has it at the boards. Hubbock just sitting there. Nobody hassling him, and that's a defensive mistake you cannot make.
That is shocking defending from the Warriors there. They're all out on the perimeter. And Hubbock has all the time in the world to put that one in.
I've played centre, and that's a centreman's dream. To be just left out in space like that with no one but the goalie facing you.
And Chase. Selby tries to keep that in. Doesn't manage to. He'll just dump that back in. Lawson plays it for Brummett. 5 minutes or so remaining in the second period. Space again from a Williams, and Whitley have done it again. They've left the player all alone in front of the net. And look at Reece for Williams come across the front of the shot here. Look at the space he's in. There's no player within 10 feet of him.
You cannot, especially with Reece Williams. He said to me last year, I score most of my goals from 5 feet out. You cannot give a player like Reece Williams that kind of space in front of the net. And I think Gary Dowd and Richard Lawson will be giving the lashes in the dressing room to the defence over that one.
Indeed, I'm not sure how people missed him. Just no Whitney player appeared to see him. There was no forward at the point going with him. He just kind of ghosted in.
Did he come off
all
the bench?
Time and space. He may have come off the bench. Certainly. But even then, somebody should have been keeping an eye.
We were in awe of the Warriors' defense in the first period. I thought they were doing very, very well. Could be very proud of themselves this period. They have not given a very good show of themselves.
We put the mockers on them, I think. Here is Ian Powell. Jumped into the boards. Now Stevenson. And there is discussion going on the Warriors' bench, which we can hear up here. In a broadish Geordie, somebody is expressing their disapproval in the time-honoured Anglo-Saxon fashion.
Possibly Gary Dowd.
Very possibly Gary Dowd. Just under 5 minutes remaining now in the period. And two quick goals from the E&L Blaze have made it 3-1. Whitley Warriors' defence has gone to sleep a little over the past 3 minutes.
They say lightning doesn't strike twice, but it struck twice there.
Genuine, and it's covered up by Richie Lawson. If you're Gary Dowd now, what do you say to your players, apart from the obvious don't do that again?
Cover the net. Make sure, no matter what, there's somebody in front of that net. Because the Blaze, that's what the Blaze's game plan has been all evening now, as the Warriors are going to get a breakaway.
Here is Callum Patterson, and it goes off backhand. Plays it a bit hard. Ali Brummett shoots. That's way wide. Nearly poked in at the back post by Gibbon. And free again. It's 3-2. Score for the Warriors. Was that Gibbon who put that one in?
Let's have a look. Well, the puck takes a bounce off the backboards. Adam Goss goes to cover it. And then, yeah, it was Gibbon just there on the doorstep with his own, with a dig for victory goal for the Warriors to bring it back to 3-2.
Woo! More eventful period than the first one, this one.
Weakness of Tom Pease, which is that he prefers to go for hits rather than go for the stick work.
Shot from Ryder. Oh, that's a cracking drive from the blue line for Nathan Ryder. bolt from the blue line.
Let's see this again.
Caught that beautifully. I don't think Adam Goss had much chance with that one. And it's all square again. We said this was a great chance for the Warriors.
Right. Martin Crammond.
We collect. Good play by Jake Larkin. Genuine. He might get to that, Genuine. He does. Can he get a shot off? He can. Good save, Richie Lawson.
Let's see a replay of this. Here we go. Goes past. One, two. Sends the shot in, but Lawson, who could already see it, and that's the worst situation. You've just got to hit it and hope it defeats the goaltender, because the goaltender will already have his eye on it and be working out where to put his body.